the internet has taken these terms, and people who maybe not know these terms as well, and they've broadly applied it to all business. Startup has so many names and has so many definitions, I should say, and some of it some people are familiar with and others they aren't. So let's define what startup is before we have a conversation about it.
Yeah, that's one of the toughest ones. I have to tell you that there is not a real, let's say, consensus about what is a startup. Everyone defines it in a different way. Some people define themselves as a startups and they're not. Some people will not define themselves as a startup and they are, for reasons that have to do with grants that you apply for, government support and so on. But yeah, I think the most important thing, I guess, first of all, as for a startup, you kind of know it when you see it. That's the bottom line, unfortunately. Some people would try to put some kind of metrics, like it can't be more than 5 years of age. It can't have more than 10 employees and so on. We care mostly about the ingredient of innovation. Is it innovative? Does it do something in an innovative way? It can be an innovative technology, an innovative way of approaching the market and do sales in a way that nobody else is doing, finding a very specific niche that is unique. So I guess that when you look at a startup, you would more than anything would like to see if it has something unique in it. I go back to the point of, you know it when you see it, you see a few things and say, okay, this is a service provider. This is not a startup. But in other cases, you see a few things that it doesn't really matter if it's in the idea phase or if it's already making a lot of money and so on. It's all about what are you trying to build? Like, is it unique in a way? By the way, it also doesn't mean that you're going to be successful. You can have a very innovative idea that nobody needs. But then again, it would still be a startup, because that's exactly what startups are doing. Mostly they're trying to, validate some kind of an assumption in a way.
Primarily in the technology space, though, to be correct.
Although I have to say that some of them are, they can be hardware startups, or they can be, it has to do with robots, and some of them would be in biotechnology. As far as we're concerned, things like the vaccines now are also a startup in a way, because they have a lot of innovation.
Right. And I think I wanted to define that somewhat, because the internet has taken these terms, and people who maybe not know these terms as well, and they've broadly applied it to all business. And so I spend regular conversations, making sure that people are using the right definition of the word startup. Somebody will come online, they'll ask me a question about, hey, I'm trying to fund my startup for this carpet cleaning business. And I go, no, that's not a startup, right? You're not going to go out and you're not going to find angel investors. You're not going to go to Silicon Valley and find, that's what a startup is. What you're doing is you're starting a company, right? But in terms of the words that you want to use, the definition means something. And I think that has gotten, at least from my perspective, a little bit skewed up when we're talking about startups. So I wanted to make sure that we define that correctly as we start talking about startup blink. Before we do that, tell us about yourself.
Yeah, so I used to work as an accountant before I started this entrepreneurship path. And you're definitely right, Jerry, that there is a big difference between a startup founder and entrepreneur. And we have to also respect the entrepreneurs. And I think in some way, if you are opening a bakery or a carpet shop, you're still an entrepreneur, by the way, which is absolutely, we should celebrate it. But that's a point aside. So I was working in the accounting companies, and then basically got a little bit of tired of it and decided to join the startup game myself, opened an online language school back in the days. And now working on Startup Blink. I guess I try to leave the 9-to-5 path, let's say. It wasn't really the one that is interesting for me. One of the advantages, by the way, of opening a startup is that you can create something new and you can take a little bit of control on your life, on your freedom, take the plunge into total uncertainty. After that, basically, after I started Startup Blink, we started to not only build the technology that you can see in Startup Blink now. If you go there, you would see hundreds of thousands of entities, in addition to the ranking tables of 1,000 cities and 100 countries. but also doing consulting, mostly to governments and to economic development corporations. We have projects with the World Bank Group. We have projects with the United Nations and a few governments. So I'm kind of looking at myself also in the hat of not only building the technology and the databases, but also as a consultant myself, which goes back into my history, let's say.